Pilar obstruction, then Lipschitz killing curvature.
So, thank you. So, first, I thank Nivaldo and Marcelo for organizing this special session on singularity theory and for asking me to give a talk. So, my talk is about polar obstruction and curvature. So, the aim is to apply a Gauss-Bonnet formula that I prove in the four local subanalytic set to the case of complex analytic sets. So first I start recording a result about a curvature for a smooth manifold. So let's take M, a smooth manifold in some manifold in Rn with dimension between 1 and n minus 1. And first, I will recall the definition of the second fundamental form. So you pick a point x in M, and v is a unit normal vector sphere, a normal vector to M at x. So it belongs to Sx, which is a unit sphere in the normal space. This is M, this is my point X, and here at K. So what is the second fundamental form? At X in the direction of V is the following, it's the following bilinear form. So X1 and X2 are two tangent vectors to the manifold. And it's defined like that, minus, so the scalar product of the derivative of V of capital V at X apply at X1 scalar with X2. And V, capital V is a normal vector field to M, which is equal to V at X. Okay. So V, capital V is a normal vector field. Such that V of X, capital V of X is small v. Okay. So you take here vector field. At the point X, it's equal to V. So this is a bilinear symmetric form. So it has eigenvalues. And the Lipschitz-Killing curvature are defined with these eigenvalues. So in the following way. So you take I from 0 D, and the ES Lipschitz-Killing curvature is integral over the unit normal sphere of the ES elementary symmetric function of the eigenvalues of this bilinear symmetric form. So sigma I of the eigenvalues, I write this like that. So this is a ES elementary symmetric function of the eigenvalues of the second fundamental form. So ES elementary symmetric function of the eigenvalues of the second fundamental form. So this Ki are called the Lipschitz-Killing curvature. So they appear in the tube formula of Weyl, and also in the following Gauss-Bonnet formula. So when M is compact, the Euler characteristic of M is just the integral over M of Kd. So this is, and one has to divide by the volume of the sphere. So this denotes the volume of the sphere of unit sphere of dimension n minus one. So this Gauss-Bonnet theorem is due to Fenchel and Allendorfer and Weil. So not here, I forgot to say that when E is odd, I is odd, this is zero. Okay. Remark. For I odd, the ES Lipschitz-Killing curvature is zero. So now I'm going to present generalization of this result in the case of subanalytic sets. So the result I'm going to explain are due to Fu and Zhou Fu and Broecker, Wernig and Kuppe. So I consider a compact subanalytic set in Rn. So this is compact and subanalytic. And I consider a Wittner stratification of this this set. So this is a partition into a strata. So this is Wittner stratification. And I want to define a similar curvature as a Ki. So so first I will explain for a stratum how we can define this curvature for a stratum of dimension. So V is stratum and its dimension is between 1 and n minus 1. Okay. Here my set can be of dimension n. There's no restriction. So first I define for this strata, I will define a curvature. So so I call the dimension of V, I call it D. So I do how do I do? So I take K between 0 and D, and I want to define a Lipschitz-Killing curvature. So it's better if I write here. So I define lambda k of V at x. So it is similar to this definition. So I take the integral over the unit normal sphere to the strata V. Sx is a unit normal sphere to my stratum. I consider the d minus k ES elementary symmetric form of the second fundamental form. But here I add an index that I call alpha xz. So you see this is nearly the same definition, except that I need to add here an index. And I will define this index now. So it is a normal Morse index. So alpha xv is a normal index. It's a normal Morse index of the function V star, which is a scalar product with V. So of V star restricted to V star of V. So V star is just a scalar product, usual Swallow's product with V. So how is it defined? So this is a normal Morse index. This is 1 minus the Euler characteristic of x intersected with nx intersected with a small ball centered at x and intersected with a negative minor fiber at x of this v star. So this is v star equal v star of x minus delta. So delta is positive, smaller than epsilon, and epsilon is very small, as usual. And here, this is a normal slice to v at x. So nx, normal slice to v at x. So this means this is a affine space that intersects v transversely, and the intersection is just the point x. So let me give some examples of this alpha v. So first case, I will consider a manifold with boundary. So examples. So I assume x is this manifold with boundary. So I pick a point at the boundary, x. So the normal slice is just a line. So this is a normal slice. And we have two normal vectors, unit normal vectors. So v plus point outwards. So the minor fiber for v plus, you just take a ball and you intersect with a negative level. So you see, this is this segment, so the Euler characteristic is 1, so the index is 0. No, sorry. I have to intersect with the normal slice. So here, the fiber is just this point. And so the index is 0. Now, if I consider the other normal vector, the one that points inwards, v minus, then the fiber, the minor fiber, the negative minor fiber is this point. Actually, this point intersected with x, so it is empty. So the index is 1. Okay. So now let's consider manifold with a corner. More complicated example. So I consider this quarter space. Okay. So I take a point here in this line. The normal space is a vertical plane. So the normal slice is this. So if I just draw the situation in the normal slice. So this is x intersected with normal slice is just this square. So you have two kind of vector, of normal vectors. The one that point inward, then the situation, the minor fiber is this segment, but it doesn't intersect x. So the minor fiber as Euler is empty, so Euler characteristic is 0, so the index is 1. And if I take a unit vector that points outwards, like that, call it W, then the minor fiber is this segment, so it has Euler characteristic 1, so the index is 0. Okay, so this is an easy example to explain this this index. So now, so I have defined the function lambda for k between 0 and d. So for k greater than d, we put 0. So for k greater than d, lambda k is 0. So now I have to consider two kinds of strata of dimension 0 and strata of dimension n. Okay. So if the dimension of V is n, then we put lambda 0 equal lambda n minus 1 equals 0 and lambda n equals 1. And if the dimension of V is 0, then we put lambda 0 is just the integral over the sphere of this indices. So this is maybe I have forgotten something. Yes, here I have to divide by the volume of the sphere of dimension n minus k minus 1. So here I divide by the volume of the sphere of dimension n minus 1, and I take the integral of the indices alpha x v. And for k greater than 0, I put lambda k equal 0. Okay. So now I can define the Lipschitz-Killing curvature. I just take the sum over all the strata of the lambda k. So definition. So I take U, a Borel set in X. So what is the Lipschitz-Killing measure lambda k evaluated on U? It's just the sum of all the lambda k of the integral of the lambda k over V over each strata intersected with U. So this is the sum. Of the lambda k, the integral of the lambda k on each strata, each stratum intersected with you. Okay. So let me give maybe an example. So I will consider this example of a manifold with a boundary of dimension n. So it has two strata, the interior and the boundary. Okay. So so the interior is has a dimension n, and the boundary a dimension n minus 1. So what is gamma n, if U is a Borel set of X? So this is just the Lebesgue measure of dimension n of U. Okay. Because since the boundary has dimension less than has dimension n minus 1, it does not contribute to this Lipschitz-Killing measure. And what are the other lambda n, lambda k? They are just the integral on the on u intersected with the boundary of the elementary symmetric function of the principal curvature. Okay. So this is. This is 1 over Sn minus k minus 1 of the integral on the boundary of the n minus 1 minus ks elementary symmetric function of the principal curvature of the boundary. Okay. So what is the Gauss-Bonnet formula in this context? So the Gauss-Bonnet formula, so you suppose X compact, and you have that the Euler characteristic of X is a Lipschitz-Killing measure lambda zero applied on X. Okay. So in this, in the case where you have a manifold with boundary, then we recover the fact that the Euler characteristic is the integral of the Gauss curvature of the boundary. So X is a manifold with boundary, we have that this lambda zero it's just when you put k equals zero here, just 1 over S minus 1 over the integral of the integral over the boundary of sigma n minus 1 of the principal curvature. This is just the usual Gauss-Bonnet formula for manifold this boundary. This is the Gauss, this is the Gauss curvature of the boundary. Okay, so now I will apply this result to complex case. I need one more theorem, the theorem I will apply in the complex case. So I proved, so this is a global Gauss-Bonnet formula. So I prove a local Gauss-Bonnet formula. So you assume that X is a closed subanalytic set, and zero belongs to X. So I've proved this following formula. 1 is equal to the sum from k equals 0 to the dimension of x of a limit of Gauss-Bonnet Lipschitz-Killing curvature. So this is the limit as epsilon tends to 0 of the Lipschitz-Killing curvature lambda k applied on x intersected with a small ball and divided by bk. So this is the volume of the unique ball of dimension k divided by. So this is a local Gauss-Bonnet formula because this is the Euler characteristic of X intersected with a small ball. So now let's apply this formula to the complex case. So I need to introduce some material. So complex case. So X so is an analytic germ in Cn. So it is reduced, and I assume it has a dimension d. So it is equipped with a witness stratification, finite witness stratification, zero. So it is a witness stratification. And for simplicity, I will assume that the origin is a stratum. But it's not necessary, but just for simplicity. So each VI are reduced, and the closure each VI is connected, and the closure of each strata is a reduced analytic set. Okay, so this is a global, the general situation. So first, I need to define the complex link. So the complex link is a very important object in for the study of a complex analytic set. So let me define it. So I pick a strata, a point in a stratum, and the complex link, just like in the real case, I consider a minor fiber of a generic projection and intersect with a normal slice. So this is X intersected with a normal slice, intersected with a small ball, and intersected by with the minor fiber of a generic projection. So this is a complex link. So nx, so we always have this inequality. So nx is just an affine normal line to V, normal slice. And L is a generic linear form on the normal slice. So two important remarks. The homotopy type of this link does not depend on the choice, on L and X. So it does not depend on the choice of the point X and all the choices made to define it. And if I see X as a real analytic set in R2N, then 1 minus the Euler characteristic of this complex link is exactly the index alpha XV I defined for V generic. For V generic, not for all V, but for V generic. So this is a result of Goretzky and McPherson. So this is a complex link. And now I will define kind of generalization of this complex link. So I consider, let's put it one here. I consider a constructible function, X to Z. So a constructible function is an integer value function, which is constant on each strata. So this is a constructible. So we can write it like that, sum of mi, 1 of vi. And I define now the normal Morse index of beta. On a stratum V. So this is, I will define eta, I will write it eta V beta. So this is beta of X. So X is a point in V. So the value of beta at X minus the sum of the MI times the Euler characteristic of the complex link intersected with VI. Okay. So when beta is 1, you recover 1 minus the Euler characteristic of the complex link. So now third object I have to introduce is the Euler obstruction. Okay, so I think that most of you know what the Euler obstruction is. So now I need to assume that X is equidimensional. So I won't give the original definition of the Euler obstruction. It's too complicated. I will give a characterization due to Léon Tessier. So the Euler obstruction of X at the point 0 is just a sum of from k equal 1 to d minus 1 d to the d minus k times the multiplicity of the generic polar curve at the origin, the generic polar curve of codimension d minus k. A polar curve is just a polar variety. Is just you take the critical set on the regular part. You take a generic projection, consider the critical set of the generic projection on the regular part of X, and you take the closure. Okay. So let me just give a picture. You project on this plane. So the polar variety is just this. Okay. So, what are the properties of the Euler obstruction? Quickly, so it is additive. So, the Euler obstruction of the union of x and y is just the sum of the Euler obstruction. It is constructible. So this is a result of Brasley and Schwartz. And yes, it has a nice relation with the normal Morse index. So if you take the normal Morse index of a stratum V prime at a stratum V prime of the Euler obstruction on the closure of V. So it is 1 if V prime is equal to V, and T0 otherwise. Okay. So this is a result of Jörg-Schurmann. So now, okay. I have introduced all the objects, so I can state the main theorem. So main theorem. So the situation is this one. X is a reduced analytic. Dimension D, and it is stratified. And each, I will call DI the dimension of the strata VI. Okay. So this is the situation. So I take phi, a constructible function on X. And I will express phi of 0 in terms of the Lipschitz scaling obstruction of the strata, Lipschitz scaling curvature of the strata VI, and the normal marks, normal Morse indices. So let me state the formula. So phi of zero, so it is a normal index at the strata V0 plus, so the sum from I equal 1 to Q of the sum from E equal 1 to DI. And here I have limits of integral of Lipschitz scaling curvature. So this is 1 over B to E epsilon to the 2E, 1 over, so 2N minus 2 minus 1. So this is a universal coefficient. And here I have the integral over VI intersected with B epsilon of the Lipschitz scaling curvature of index 2 DI minus 2 E. And I have to multiply with the normal, so maybe, so this. I multiply with a normal Morse index of phi. Okay, so this is a formula. So to prove it, it's just an application of the local Gauss formula, the local Gauss Bonnet formula. So proof, just apply the local Gauss Bonnet formula. And you use the fact that the index alpha xv that appears in the local in the real case, it is constant on the strata. Okay. So apply yes no sorry. Because everything is additive, you just have to prove it for the indicatrix function on x. So just have to prove it for. Phi equal 1 of x, and you just apply the local Gauss Bonnet formula. Gauss Bonnet formula. And use the fact that alpha xv is just. Okay. It's constant. So this is n for x in v. So that's why this you can take it out of the integral, and then you just use the fact that if I is odd, the Lipschitz curvature is zero. Ki is zero if I is odd. Okay. So to finish, I just give a corollary. So corollary. So we apply it to when phi is order obstruction. So what happens if phi is the Euler obstruction of x? This will vanish, except if v is a stratum of the regular set. And then we will just keep the integral over the regular set of x. So the formula, so phi. Maybe I should add the assumption that x is equidimensional. And then the order obstruction of x at zero is a sum from E equals 1 to D. The limit as epsilon tends to 0. So here we have V2. And here we have the integral of the Lipschitz Killing curvature K 2D minus 2E on the regular part. Okay. So I stop here.